February 23rd, 2011. As the GOI-1 satellite passes over New Brunswick, southeastern Canada, it spots a star shape.
Looks to me like a flower imprinted in the snow. But clearly it's much too big for that.
It's obvious that this isn't just carved out into the snow. It's something that's underneath the snow.
For some investigators, the location of the weird outline is intriguing.
The pentagram is the classic symbol of witchcraft.
This area is over the US border from Salem, Massachusetts, which is famously known for the Salem witch trials.
In colonial Massachusetts at the end of the 17th century, officials accuse over 200 people in Salem of practicing sorcery, among them, 8 children.
Just imagine the terror and the horror that would have come with being accused of witchcraft. You're done for.
13 women are found to be witches, 6 men of being sorcerers. They are all hanged. A suspect who refuses to cooperate is slowly killed over 3 days by having heavy stones placed on his chest, a torture known as pressing.
At this time, people were killed just for rumors of practicing witchcraft.
A number of the accused flee. Some suspect across the Canadian border to the spot captured in the satellite image.
Looking at this satellite image and knowing the history of witchcraft in the area, could this be some kind of ritual site that was used by witches in the past?
When investigators closely analyze the perimeter of the mystery star, they find another clue. One that suggests a defensive purpose.
One of the things that's obvious is that this isn't just a structure, but there are actually ditches dug around it.
Looking at it more closely, it looks a lot like the shape of a medieval fortress.
Military historians confirm that the structure's location is key. This area was of strategic importance to European colonists. It sits on a strip of land separating New Brunswick and Nova Scotia, a key point on an important trade route in the 18th century.
For both the French and the British, this is the gateway to North America, to the New World. It's along the St. Lawrence Seaway, the major riverine passage into the interior of Canada and upper United States from Europe, from the Atlantic.
Rich Europeans want fur caught by Canadian trappers. The valuable pelts are transported from the remote Canadian wilderness along the St. Lawrence River.
The vast potential of the natural resources of Canada was a magnet to both the French colonizers, the British colonizers, and made this place vitally strategic.
In the mid-18th century, France controls New Brunswick. Britain governs Nova Scotia. Historian KERI MERRITT believes the snow-covered structure is a fort which played a key role in their bitter and bloody conflict.
Records reveal that this fort was actually Fort Beauséjour, which was created by the French in 1751 in order to protect themselves against the British.
The British have their own fort, Fort Lawrence, just 2 miles away. But the star shape of Fort Beauséjour, known as a bastion fort, gives the French the advantage.
The star shape is effective because the pointed bastions mean that they can attack in multiple directions and they don't have blind spots around the fort.
Nevertheless, on June 3rd, 1755, 2,000 British troops mount a ferocious assault on the French fort. The British besiege and relentlessly bombard the fort. Starving, wounded, surrounded by corpses and human filth, 160 French colonists are trapped in the fort.
Can you imagine being in this fort when you're actually under siege? The screams, the smells, the horror.
There's nowhere to go, nowhere to hide. What is your hope? Either that more French defenders will come to your aid, or that the British besiegers will be merciful.
The British blockade of a nearby port prevents French reinforcements from rescuing their comrades. On June 16th, the French surrender, and Britain subsequently gains control of the St. Lawrence River, its trade, and its vast natural resources.
By seizing control of this French fort as well as others, the British have in effect taken a monopoly on this part of the world and the resources that are coming in and going out of it.
Beausejour becomes a crucial staging post for Britain's eventual military domination of Canada. Today, it endures as a haunting reminder of North America's bloody colonial era.